Struggling with acne and feel like you have tried everything to eliminate your breakouts? In this video, we share with you the real reasons why you have acne and how to clear your skin. Within our skin, attached to our hair follicle, we have our sebaceous gland, which its job is to create sebum, oil, to lubricate and protect the skin. And when you have acne, you have an inflamed sebaceous gland that is producing too much oil. And the thing is, bacteria loves oil and gets involved, which then tells our immune system to send in white blood cells to get rid of the infection. And infection leads to swelling, redness, and pus within the skin, and results in a pustule or cyst, depending on how deep the infection is. Multiple factors can stimulate acne being produced, which involves a shift in hormones, a deficiency in vitamin D, poor oil quality, and an unbalanced skin pH. Now, the real reason a shift in hormones can stimulate acne is because there is a spike in androgens. Females with PCOS also produce too many androgens, which is why acne is common across those who have PCOS. Vitamin D also regulates the sebaceous gland to ensure you are not producing too much oil. The vitamin also keeps bacteria at bay that is involved with acne. It inhibits it, so when you are deficient in vitamin D, you will not have a control over the bacteria and the oil production. Vitamin D also helps regulate overproduction of androgens in the body. Now, many factors can cause vitamin D deficiency. However, that is why if you have acne, we recommend to get some hormonal testing done to check if there's anything unbalanced and go from there. When it comes to our oil quality that our sebaceous gland is producing, we want our oil to be free-flowing, thin, and come through that hair follicle onto the skin easily. The reason we need it to be free-flowing is because our hair follicle runs through the dermis and towards the top layer of the skin, the epidermis. The follicle's passageway becomes a lot smaller and thinner. So if you have thick, unhealthy oil coming through the hair follicle, it's going to create blockages on the way up because it's a slower moving and it's struggling to get through that hair follicle. So once that happens, it creates a blockage within the hair follicle underneath the skin because oil gets trapped, bacteria then feeds, and our immune system sends in white blood cells to get rid of the blockage and infection. Now, to avoid this from occurring, you need to balance your oil flow and encourage the quality of your oil flow to be nice and thin. So include omega-3s in your diet and a whole food to encourage healthy thin oil, such as flax seeds, chia seeds, walnuts, or even fish oil in the liquid form. Now, your skin's pH also is a factor and requires to be between 4.5 and 6.5. And acne skin is often unbalanced. So if your skin's pH is out of balance, your skin's immune system is weaker, and you are exposed to bacteria and pathogens. Your oil will also be trying to compensate, and your sebaceous gland will produce more oil. To encourage a healthy skin pH, stop scrubbing the skin with physical exfoliants or harsh foaming cleansers that contain SLS, as these strip the skin of its natural oils and break down the skin's barrier. Often those with acne think they need to wash their face more or scrub their face more to get cleaner skin, which in fact, it's actually the opposite. You need to have a healthy skin barrier to protect your skin, which involves healthy thin oil, able to absorb nutrients and vitamin D. Other vitamins great to help with acne are zinc, vitamin B3, and vitamin A. Of course, we then recommend skincare actives like vitamin B3, retinol, and salicylic acid. Vitamin B3 to encourage a healthy skin barrier and reduce inflammation. Retinol to regulate the sebaceous gland and salicylic acid to penetrate through your oil and clean out the blockages within the skin while stimulating cell turnover. Zinc is also anti-inflammatory and can be used as a mineral sunscreen. There you have it, the real reasons you have acne. If you were not sure if you have an impaired skin barrier, then check out this video here to learn more.